We are exploring tides, what they are, what causes them,
and why most beaches get two tides a day.
Bringing in my furry friends, Sunny and Luna, to help me out. Are you ready? Let's go!
So tides are the ups and downs of the water level throughout the day on the shoreline. So when you go to the beach, sometimes the water level will be way up the shore, right? And then other times of the day, the water level is further back. That's a tide.
Some areas have a huge difference between high tide and low tide. So you better not leave your beach towel out or it'll get covered.
What causes these tides to happen?
Well, the answer is not on our planet.
The answer is in the sky.
Yeah, the moon and the sun are what's behind the tides.
So to help you see this, I'm bringing in my friends Sunny and Luna.
Aww. Aren't they adorable?
We've got Sunny
that represents the sun. We have Luna that represents the moon. And we have our human that represents the earth. Okay, got it?
The sun and the moon are constantly pulling on Earth, and Earth pulls on them back. This pulling is called gravity. It's the attraction of objects that have mass toward each other. It's what holds us to this Earth, and it's what causes the planets to orbit around the sun and moons to orbit around planets. This pull causes the ocean to be distorted into an egg shape, and the ends of the egg follow the moon. Why does this egg shape follow the moon?
Well, Luna here is showing us how it's done.
She's closer to the Earth, and that is what causes the tides to have a stronger pull that faces the moon. The sun is still tugging, but we just don't see as much of an effect from the sun's pull. Okay, so we know that gravity is causing these tides to happen, but what does it look like on Earth? What's our experience of it? We go through the ends of the egg twice a day because the Earth is rotating.
Here's what it looks like. Here's me, it's the morning and it's a high tide. So it's time for snorkeling.
Then 6 hours later, the Earth has rotated away from the ends of the water egg. So it will be low tide.
That means I get to walk the beach to look for critters in the sand.
Then 6 hours later, now it's evening time and the Earth has rotated through the other high tide.
And then 6 hours later, it's in the middle of the night. So I'll be sleeping.
But the Earth has rotated through a low tide. The moon sneaks forward in its orbit each day. So Earth has to spin a bit longer to catch up. This means that tomorrow's tides will roll in about 50 minutes later than today's.
Most areas have two high tides and two low tides each day, but there are some areas that only have one high tide and one low tide each day. And that is due to the shape of the land and the way that the tidal current interacts with other currents. So it just depends on where you are.
Tide heights usually change throughout the month because the sun, the moon, and the earth are in different positions. When they're lined up, that's when we see the highest high tides and the lowest low tides, because the moon and the sun are combining their poles.
Now that you know how tides work, what else can I answer for you? Let me know in the comments below.
Want to see how tides get super fun? Check out my next video on 5 awesome tide facts, like spotting cool sea creatures. Watch it next. The link is below.
Thank you, Sunny and Luna. You did a fantastic job. Woohoo!